back. Now then, what I've done previously since the last time you saw is that I put a darker coat onto this. So let me just see if I can get a bit of light on it. Even though it's a bright day, I'll just get a bit of light on. See, we hope we can see. Oh dear. There we go. I've just put a darker... Come on, let's go. Just put a little bit of a darker coat on so that it looks better. So what I'm going to do now is take my semi-stippling brush. Oops, hang on. Hang on, we're not kind of... There we go. Then I've got the three colours that I need, which is the base layer, the darker layer, and also the gold. The patina is, oh, and I've got a darker colour here as well, which is, oh, I tell you, I've got colours all over the place for this. So I've got the colours, and I've got the patina, which is this one. This is the one's going to give the patina look. Now, let's start, shall we? Just get me brush wet first. There we go. Not bothered with it, get a bit wet. And then let's start, shall we? And all I'm going to do is, I'm just going to go random is. Not bothered where things are. In fact, I might give this a little, hang on, a little bit of a stir. There we go. Good. Right. We're just going to blast this. We want to... It'll all soon come into play. Let's get that a little bit over here. I think that's enough. Now, let's get the darker one in. Now with this, we don't want to go over a lot of the orange. We just want to kind of melt it, you know, not melt it in, but bring it in. So that... they look like they were there together. Then add a bit of the darker colour in. So that we're going all over the place. This is a bit of a lighter colour. Add a bit of the orange. We'll come back to that. Let's add some dark into here. Sorry, you can't really see what's going on, can you? It does look awful at the moment. It doesn't look like it's anything. But trust me, once we start getting things, maybe if I bring this forward a little bit and then bring you in. Whoops, I've got to do this one-handed. There, maybe that's better. Let's bring a bit of dark into here. And then it's slowly getting there. Right, let's have a little bit of brighter colours there. And a bit of darker, and a bit more darker there. There we go. Now, it doesn't look like anything at the moment because we've not really got the gold in. Which gives it that kind of, you know what you do kind of thing. At the moment, we're just putting on layers of this paint. That we hope will make it into. See, I can see some bits there that need a little bit of working out. And then let's go down to the bottom and add, oops, my nose is running. Add some more there. There we go, I think we're slowly getting there. I think what we need to do now is to get this to dry so that we can then bring a bit of highlight to it in. Because we don't want it to be so let's bring that down to there. And then, I am sorry if I do go out of shot, but can you see how the sand that we added has broken it all up? So, and it's made it, I don't know, maybe with this sand, I put a little bit too much sand in. I don't know. Even now I'm sort of doubting what I'm doing. I just need to do a little bit of I went out of the shot then. To get some darker in now. So mix all this in. It's gone all. Right. Do we think that this is going to work? Well, I certainly hope so. As I say, it's all done by trial and error. Hi there. Hope everyone's keeping safe and well during this this time of well, pressure. And anyway, let's not dwell on that. I just hope that you're all keeping safe and you're all keeping sane, and that includes your family and your close circle of friends. Now then, what am I going to do? It's a follow-up of the last video, and once again, if I'm waving my arms around, send in the wavy arm police and we'll see what we can do. Now then, as you know, I have been experimenting, putting things, doing up bottles and what have you. Now I have kind of, let me just take one that I've done. I just hope I don't break everything while I'm doing this. I should have got myself prepared before I did it. Right, this was, I can't remember what this jar was, but anyway, this is what I've kind of turned it into. This here, that is the netting that fruit comes in. So, and then these are just two IOD molds. I put an IOD mold across the top, and I've put one, a key, on the top, so it kind of follows a little bit of a theme. And then, as you know, this is the one that I'm playing around with at the moment. Now, I know it's dark, but there's a reason for that. I just wanted to show you, there's the angels. The angel, all the molds are IOD, and then I've done the top. Now in the top center there, I've got a little jewel, little fitting there. Now what I want to do to that is that I want to make that one rusty and patina-y, so it looks like it's been at the bottom of the sea for, like, you know, hundreds of years. So I started to play around with some paper, and this is the one, the paper, the first one, if I turn it this way, right, get it, that I played around with, and this is using the items from Luminaire. Gold. This is one of my favourite colours of all time. And then we've got the gold. And to top that, I then use some folk art rust treatment. So I use sort of them three to sort of build it up. And I thought, now that's not cheap. It's far from it. And I don't think everybody's got this kind of material. So, knowing me, I decided, now that itchy head, I have got cheap paints. I buy these, they're not expensive, they're graduate acrylics, they're very good, you get a lot of for your buck, so they say. And so I thought, I wonder if I could make my own. That's when this came in. Now this is just using, focus, just using the cheap stuff plus two other ingredients. One ingredient was mica flakes. Now I know we've not seen or used these maybe for a long, long time, but mica flakes don't need a lot, just a little bit. And then, now I knew I put it in my bag here, here it is. To top it all, I bought aquarium sand. This is just plain, straightforward, little bag of aquarium sand. You can get it all colours, but I just got the white. It's not that expensive, and I'm sure there's lots of other uses for it as well, for not just creating art. But if you want texture, it's very, very fine grain, it's very, very gritty. So there's that then. So I created my own base layer of grittiness. Now if I just, I wonder if I get a, is grittiness a word? I don't know, but if you listen carefully, Can you hear it? It gives you that, it's that texture that we want. Right, wipe that, put lid on so I don't knock it over, and I have done, and it's gone all over the floor, trust me. So, now when I'm creating these things, Joe, these little plastic tubs that you get, they've got the tops, you know, like you sometimes get, now this may sound posh, but it's not. You might get feta cheese and olives in, and they've got an oil in them. Well, I keep them little plastic tubs, because they are perfect for containing, for holding things down. If I may, I will just stretch over here. Try not to knock everything down. So this was a little tub that some mango chutney came in for our takeaway, for our Indian takeaway. And these are containers that have like the olives and the wet stuff and thing. So I don't, these are too valuable to go to landfill. So keep them and use them. I hope I'm not trying to preach, I'm not, but we've got to start thinking of, if I throw that away, however, if I keep it, how can I use it? What can I do? So this is why I'm doing all these bottles. Like I say, this was a coffee jar, a plain old glass coffee jar. But I'm hoping that once I've finished, it'll look something, it'll be, you know, it'll go on somebody's desk, go on somebody's drawer. And don't forget, I've also got the plastic thing in the top there that seals it. I'm still kind of finding trouble with the glass, because sometimes if you don't cover it properly, your paint can chip at the top. So I'm trying to still kind of working that one out, but I think I've got there. It's a case of when you do these, see, I painted the inside there, just that bit there. Stupidly, I painted it, but I didn't need to because the glass is going to cover there. So the only problem is that it's going to be white. You think of these things afterwards and you think, well, hang on a minute, it's going to be white inside, does that matter? Is the end? No, it's not really, when you come to the perspective of things. Now, the other thing I noticed about these, oh, it's got a, ooh, what's this? Brush hair. I hope I can get it off. It's got a, I think that's a brush hair. Yes, it is. Yeah. Ooh. I'm getting sidetracked now. There we go. It's off. It's left a nasty mark. Oh dear. An angel scarred. Scar-faced. Hang on. Where is that? Can you see? Scar-faced angel. Anyway. So I'm thinking that I want to start using things that we're going to be throwing away, and I don't want to throw them away. Things that are impressive. It's like, now this is where I'm going to sort of get on a little soapbox. I hope you don't mind. Please bear with me. It's like, why are we using so much plastic? It's like a lot of places now, they're using bamboo straws, which are brilliant. They're using the one-time or minimal-use straws that, after a little while, start to degrade, go soft, and then you can put them, and you can put them in your garden, and then you can put them with the, you can create your own fertilizer. We've got two at the moment. We've got a big turly whirly one, but at the moment, I put some raw eggs in there. Oh, the flies! Anyway, so that's that bit. What else have I got to say? What did I want to tell you? There's other, some other stuff that I wanted to tell you that I thought. Anyway, this is the intro to what I'm going to be doing with the brown glass jar. So I hope you like it. I hope, as I'm saying, I'm not here to get, oh no, please subscribe and you'll get X amount, blah, blah, blah. I'm not here for that. I'm just, if I get five, I've got like, I don't know, 400 and something. That to me is amazing. I didn't think I'd get one. But to get four, it's about 417 last time I looked. And I am appreciative of all those 417 people that clicked the subscribed button. It means such a lot to me, and I'm very, very grateful to you. It means that you like what I do, and I hope I bring not just showing you how to do things, I bring a bit of lightheartedness to it as well. So anyway, that's that, and I promise I will try not to use the word anyway and wave my hands around. Now, I can't promise it. I can't promise it, but I will do my best to... Oh, sorry, we've been watching Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., binge-watching this. Watch two episodes per night, sometimes three. All depends on how the second one ends. Now, I kind of watched that earlier when it first came out, and I thought, yeah, okay. Love it. But see, I need something to... Kind of Game of Thrones is like... You know, it's good. You know what I mean? That you kind of miss it. I know you're going to say, Alan, you're a sad old sod. Get a life. Get a grip. But, hang on, what's that? I think Amazon are calling. So I shall shut down now. I will say thank you very much. And I will do what I need to do. Okay, till the next segment. Bye-bye. I've done my trial and error. I've kind of got the res done. So now, what I'm going to start doing, I think, is it's kind of, I've got the thing, I need to get some darker patches. I think because I may have got a bit too much. I got a bit too much orange in it. But I'm just going to give this a go by adding this darker colour in to knock it back a bit. And then we'll just take it from there, shall we? Maybe I need to clean my brush because it's been pounding away with all the different colours on it. So maybe I need to just... Let's just get this back a bit. Now then. This is the point where we're going to start adding the gold. Right. As you can see, it's just gently adding it in and then knocking it back. And then what I'll do is that when it's dried, I will then add bit more colour to it, but I want to bring it in. Can you see? And maybe bring this in here. But yeah. Might be a bit too, I might have gone a bit too heavy with the other paints. I don't know yet. But we'll just add the gold onto here. So it looks like gold where it was originally gold. And then let's just put a bit of gold around there. And a bit of gold. Right, now, I think that is going to have to wait now. I may have gone a little bit over with it, so I'm now going to have to let it dry, and then I'm going to knock it back, because I think I've gone, it's a little bit too much, so I think I need to get some paint out and just work with the normal paints now, because I've created this nice, very rustic top. So what I need to do now is let this settle, let it form a dry skin, and then maybe then we can knock it back a little bit and there we go. Right, I just added the I think I've gone a little bit too crazy, so one brush. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put these, shut this down, wash my hands, go and make a cup of tea, and I will be back when this is dried, and then we will knock it back, and we will, with just ordinary paints with nothing to it. So for now, bye bye. Hello, well, I'm back now then. My apologies. What's happened is that I set this up, press record, carried on doing this and this, then only to realise that I didn't have a disc big enough in. And so there was me, I was yapping away and nothing was recorded. So what I will do is that I'm going to start another project showing you exactly how I did this using this one. Oops, I'm going to use this one and I will show you how I did it. That's the lid. What I've done now is, at the moment, because it was white, I've just given it a coat of black gesso. So I'll do a close-up of how this has turned out. So I hope you like it. As you can see, this was a glass jar. I've got to just put the plastic suction bit on the top there. Now this is the IOD mold, and what I've done is I've used some of the I can't remember what the name is, but I'll think it's the I've gone brain dead. Oh, I tell you, being 25 sorry. It's the metal gold leaf. It's the gold leaf, but it's a different type one that's got the sort of verdigris and everything, which I thought would go better with the overall feel how I wanted, because I wanted it to look old. And that's it. Now, as you can see, there is this is the pattern that I've done. The gold hasn't come out as much as I'd like to, because I did want to have a little bit of gold going in. So what I might do is I put one coat of Mod Podge High Gloss, Super Brilliant. What I might do is that I might just put a little bit of the, Joe, the gold leaf, and just make it look as if it'd been veined. But I think, you see, I'm pleased with how it's turned out. There's a glass bead that all I've done to it is put the gold leaf on the back, and then that's that. So that's Steve coming in now, and he's been for his walk. So this is it, this is the finished item. I hope you like it. I'll take a few photographs so that you can see. And as I say, we will take this and we will transform this into something like this. Okay, right, thanks very much for watching this, and please keep safe and keep creating. Any questions, leave them below. Don't forget, you don't have to subscribe or anything. It'd be nice if you did, but you don't have to. If you'd want to put a like on the video, then thank you. But no, I just want to say thank you for all that you've done, all your messages, and fingers crossed you like what I do and you like what I've done here. Okay, right, bye for now, and I shall speak to you soon.